said to the infant Christ, a light to lighten the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Psalms 48 and 87.
Great is the Lord, and highly to be praised. In the city of our God is his holy hill.
Beautiful and lofty, the joy of all the earth, is the hill of Zion, the very center of the world and the city of a great king.
God is in her citadel. He is known to be her sure refuge.
Behold, the kings of the earth assemble and march forward together.
They looked and were astounded. They retreated and fled in terror.
Trembling seized them then. They arrived like a woman in childbirth, like ships of the sea when the east wind shatters them.
As we have heard, so have we seen in the city of the Lord of hosts, in the city of our God. God has established her forever.
We have waited in silence on your loving kindness, O God, in the midst of your temple.
Your praise, like your name, O God, reaches to the altar. Your right hand is full of justice.
Let not Zion be glad, and the cities of Judah rejoice, because of your judges.
Make the circuit of Zion, walk round about her. Count the number of her towers.
Consider well her bulwarks. Examine her strongholds, that you may tell those who come after.
This God is our God forever and ever. He shall be our guide forevermore. On the holy mountain stands the city he has founded. The Lord loves the gates of Zion more than all the dwellings of Jacob.
Glorious things are spoken of you, O city of our God.
I count Egypt and Babylon among those who know me. Behold, Philistia, Tyre, and Ethiopia, in Zion were they born.
Of Zion shall be said, every one was born in her, and the Most High himself shall
that saw this house in its former glory. How does it look to you now? Is it not in your sight as nothing? Yet now take courage, O Zerubbabel, says the Lord. Take courage, O Joshua, son of Jehozadak, the high priest. Take courage, all you people of the land, says the Lord. Work, for I am with you, says the Lord of hosts, according to the promise that I made you when you came out of Egypt. My spirit abides among you, do not fear. For thus says the Lord of hosts, once again in a little while, and I will shake the heavens and the earth and the sea and the dry land, and I will shake all the nations, so that the treasure of all nations shall come, and I will fill this house with splendor, says the Lord of hosts. The silver is mine, and the gold is mine, says the Lord of hosts. The latter splendor of this house shall be greater than the former, says the Lord of hosts. And in this place I will give prosperity, says the Lord of hosts. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. First letter of John, the third chapter, beginning at the first verse. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. Everyone who commits sin is guilty of lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. You know that he was revealed to take away sins, and in him there is no sin. No one who abides in him sins. No one who sins has either seen him or known him. Little children, let no one deceive you. Everyone who does what is righteous, just as he is righteous. Everyone who commits sin is a child of the devil, for the devil has been sinning from the beginning. The Son of God was revealed for this purpose, to destroy the works of the devil. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful,
we entreat you, O Lord,
that your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill.
We entreat you, O Lord,
that we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses.
We entreat you, O Lord,
that there may be peace to your church and to the whole world.
We entreat you, O Lord,
that we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ.
We entreat you, O Lord,
that we may be bound together by your Holy Spirit in the communion of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Evangelist, St. Simeon and all your saints, entrusting one another and all our life to Christ.
We entreat you, O Lord.
Almighty and everlasting God, we humbly pray that as your only begotten Son was this day presented in the temple, so we may be presented to you with pure and clean hearts by Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Most holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works, give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of all enemies, may live in peace and quietness, through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Saviour.
Amen.
A light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, stay with us, for evening is at hand and the day is past. Be our companion in the way, kindle our hearts, and awaken hope, that we may know you as you are revealed in Scripture and the breaking of bread. Grant this for the sake of your love.
Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all ever.